Bernie Geoffrion, one of the most iconic players ever to wear the famous Montreal Canadiens sweater, also possessed one of the most memorable nicknames in NHL history.
Bernie Geoffrion was very inventive, let's put it that way. He got this idea of, instead of doing the wrist shot or the backhand shot, I'm going to wind up and do it golf style. And it worked. It worked so well that he continued to develop it in practice. And one day, during a practice, one of the French-Canadian writers named Charlie Bois happened to watch him. And what impressed Charlie Bois was the whack of the puck against the stick, and if it missed the net, which it often did, the whack against the board. So it was boom, boom. Hence, he nicknamed him Boom Boom Geoffrion.
Boom Boom's devastating slap shot helped him produce 30 goals on the way to winning the Calder Trophy in the 1951-52 season.
It was sort of like going from propeller-driven planes to jets. That shot had the effect of putting the fear of God in every single opposition goalie. They were intimidated because we're talking about the start of the 50s. Nobody was wearing a mask, and this guy is firing the puck at speeds they never saw before. And on top of that, because he had been practicing it so much, it had uncanny accuracy.
Bernie really popularized the slap shot, and understand that he had just the flat blade stick. He didn't have the big hook that Bobby Hull and Stan Mikita would have later on that would terrorize goaltenders. But the Boomer had a very heavy shot, and the only thing heavier and louder than Boomer's shot would have been Boomer himself.
Geoffrion's game featured much more than an overpowering shot. His intensity and all-out attacking style helped power the Canadiens to the Stanley Cup in 1953. He would then win the first of his two Art Ross trophies as the league's top scorer, to the dismay of many fans in Montreal, when he overtook the suspended Maurice Richard in the final games of the 1954-55 season.
It did eat at the Boomer a bit because he felt that he had worked very hard, and he had, to be in the position to win the scoring championship. He didn't want to win it that way with the Rockets sidelined by suspension.
The fans ultimately forgave Geoffrion for upstaging their hero as the Canadiens became a dynasty, winning five consecutive Stanley Cups from 1956 to 1960.
Bernie's whole passion in life, more than the average player, more than the average star, was scoring goals. And he was a superior player on all levels. What better line mates than to have Jean Béliveau at center and the best corner man in the league in Bert Olmsted? I mean, that's like a line made in heaven. So if you have a guy like Béliveau, who's arguably the best passer in the history of the game, feeding you, then on top of that, you're playing the point on a power play, boy, oh boy, are you going to have a ball, and he did.
In 1960-61, Geoffrion became the second player in NHL history to score 50 goals in a season and captured both the Hart and Art Ross trophies.
He played the game the way it should be played. He tried to outskate you, thank you, pass you, shoot you, score you. If you score 50 goals in a year, you got to be able to shoot the biscuit.
Boom Boom's number five was retired on the day he died in 2006. His legacy and unforgettable nickname will live forever.